Welcome to Understand the Math. This video is part of a series of videos on linear algebra and its applications and covers section 4.3 part 1 on finding a basis for a vector space. I'll teach you what a basis is and walk through example problems where we'll determine if a given set is a basis for a vector space. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can highlight and fill in as you watch this video. Let's start by learning what a basis is. A basis is the minimal set of vectors that can be used to construct every vector in a vector space through linear combinations. The basis of a vector space satisfies two properties. The first property is linear independence. This means that the vectors in the set are linearly independent. The second property is called spanning the space. The set of vectors spans the entire space, which means that every vector can be written as a linear combination of the vectors in the basis. I'm now going to outline a method for how we can check if a set of vectors is linearly independent. Recall that a set of vectors V1 through VP in a vector space V is linearly independent if the equation C1 V1 plus C2 V2 all the way up through CP VP is equal to 0 has only the trivial solution, and that trivial solution is just that all the C's are equal to 0. There are two ways that we can test if a set of vectors is linearly independent. The first way is to place the set of vectors in a matrix, reduce the matrix to echelon form, and then check for pivots in each column. If every column has a pivot, then our set is going to be linearly independent because this equation up above will only have the trivial solution. If a column is missing a pivot, the set will not be linearly independent. The second way to check if a set of vectors is linearly independent or not is to find the determinant of the vectors. This method can be used if the number of vectors is equal to the number of components in each vector. When this is true, the matrix that contains the vectors will be square, and you can take the determinant. If the determinant is not equal to 0, the matrix that contains the vectors is invertible, and that means that the set of vectors is linearly independent. Likewise, if the determinant is equal to 0, that means the matrix is not invertible and the set of vectors is not linearly independent. Let's now talk about the method that we can use to check if a set of vectors spans the space. That's the second criteria for a set of vectors to be a basis. A set of vectors V1 through VP in a vector space V spans V if the equation C1 V1 plus C2 V2 all the way up through CP VP is equal to a vector B has a solution for every B. This just means that B can be written as a linear combination of the vectors in the set. Just like with linear independence, there are two ways to test if a set of vectors spans the space. The first way is to place the set of vectors in a matrix, reduce it to echelon form, and check for pivots in each row. If every row has a pivot, then every vector B can be written as a linear combination of the vectors in the set, and we can say that the vectors in the set span our vector space. If a row is missing a pivot, the set of vectors in the set will not span the vector space. The second method that we can use is if the number of vectors in our set is equal to the number of components in each vector, just like we did for checking linear independence. If the determinant is not equal to 0, the vectors span the space. And if the determinant is equal to 0, then the vectors do not span the space. Let's now pull the concept of linear independence and spanning the set together. If the number of vectors in the set is the same as the number of components in each vector, then the determinant can be used to check for both linear independence and spanning the set at the same time. I want to point out one more thing. When the determinant of a matrix is not equal to 0, the matrix is invertible, And because of this, we can say that the columns of any invertible matrix form a basis for Rn. Before we do some examples, let's take a moment to talk about standard bases. A standard basis is the most straightforward basis for a vector space and contains basic vectors where each one represents one axis or one component of the space. Every vector in the space can then be written in terms of the standard basis vectors. The standard basis for R2 contains the vectors E1 and E2. Every vector in R2 then, written as V is equal to AB, can be written like this in terms of our standard basis vectors. We say that vector V is A times E1 plus B times E2. Just like R2, our standard basis vectors for R3 are E1, E2, and E3. The standard basis for M22, the set of all 2x2 matrices, contains the matrices E11, E12, E21, and E22. Any 2x2 matrix can be written as a linear combination of these matrices. We say that matrix A is A times E11 plus B times E12 plus C times E21 plus D times E22. Lastly, the standard basis for P2, the set of all polynomials of the form A0 plus A1x plus A2x squared, contains the terms 1, x, and x squared. Let's now walk through two examples where we'll determine if a given set is a basis for a vector space. In example one, we'll determine if the given sets are a basis for R2. Our first set contains the vectors 1, 1 and -1, 1. Since there are two vectors in the set and two entries in each vector, we can use a determinant to determine if the set is linearly independent and spans R2. We have to check both of these things to determine if the set is a basis. We'll take the determinant of these two vectors. This is equal to 1 plus 1, which is 2, and it's not equal to 0. That tells us that these two vectors are linearly independent and they span R2. If we graph these vectors, we can see that the span of these two vectors is a plane, and that means that all vectors in R2 can be written in terms of these basis vectors. Our second set contains the vectors 1, 1, and 2, 2. Just like in part A, we're going to take the determinant of these vectors, and this determinant is equal to 2 minus 2, which is equal to 0. This means that the vectors in the set are not a basis for R2. If we graph the two vectors, we can see that the span of these two vectors is a line and that all vectors in R2 cannot be written in terms of these two vectors. Only vectors that lie along this line can be written in terms of those two vectors. Our last set contains three vectors. To determine if this set is a basis, we have to put our vectors into a matrix and put this matrix in echelon form. This matrix is actually already in echelon form, so we don't have to do any work, and we can just go ahead and circle our pivots. To check for linear independence, we need to see if every column has a pivot. Notice that column 3 is missing a pivot. And because of this, not every column has a pivot, and we say that the vectors are linearly dependent. If we label our vectors V1, V2, and V3, you can see that V3 is equal to 2 times V1 plus 7 times V2. This is called a dependence relationship. Let's now check to see if our vectors span R2. To do that, we have to see if every row has a pivot. And you can see that row 1 and row 2 both have pivots. So we say that our vectors span R2. Because the first property is not met, we say that the set is not a basis for R2. The last example that we'll walk through is to determine if the given set is a basis for R3. Notice that we have three vectors and three entries in each vector, so we can take the determinant of these vectors to determine if the set is a basis for R3. To evaluate this determinant, I'm going to find the determinant by doing cofactor expansion down the first column. This gives us 3 times the determinant 1175 minus 6 times the determinant minus 4 minus 2, 1, 1. This is equal to 3 times 5 minus 7 minus 6 times minus 4 plus 2. This gives us a minus 6 plus 12, which is equal to 6, and it's not equal to 0. This means that 1, our set, is linearly independent, and 2, that our set spans R3. Both requirements are met, so we can say that the set is a basis for R3. Be sure to check out the next video in this series where I'll teach you all about the basis for the null space and column space of a matrix. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.